Nicola has just released her autobiography. It's called Believe. I love the photo of you on the front of it. I think it's great. Oh, it just sums you up, you know. It really does. You look fantastic. I'm absolutely like a warrior. We saw there, you've got to put the graft in, haven't you? You don't get nothing for nothing. And you work really, really hard.
Yeah, I do. I train three times a day, 5 days a week.
Do you enjoy it, though? Do you enjoy the training, or is it just a bit of a slog sometimes?
No, no, I enjoy the training. Yeah. It's because I have goals to achieve and to aim for, so I know why I'm there, and it just motivates me to keep going.
Exactly. That's what I love to hear that. Now, it's interesting, because in the book, I had no idea that you were pretty frail kids. You were quite frail. You know, you had ADHD. The boxing really helped you, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. Really taught me discipline, give me something to focus on as well.
And in a way, that the condition actually, in some ways, helps.
Yeah,
strangely, but it really does. You're such a warrior, as I said. I can't believe you were ever a sort of frail kid, you know. But it's incredible what the sport has done for you, and indeed what you've done for the sport. But it really has changed your whole life.
Yeah, it has massively, and that's why I wanted to do the book. I wanted to inspire the next generation.
And 5 years ago, I mean, female boxing, it was there. It was sort of there, but now we kind of think, oh yeah, it's like every other sport, but it's really a lot of it's got to do with the fact that we got interested in it because of you, because of the Olympics.
Yeah, and it's been nice and an honour to be able to, you know, being able to help raise the level and the game of women's boxing, and now turning professional. I want to be able to do that with the professional side of boxing as well.
How has that been, turning pro? Is it a completely different ballgame? Is it totally different?
Yeah, completely different ballgame. I've had to pick my own team now. When I was on Team GB, everything's there, physios, doctors, coaches. Now I pick my own team myself, working away in San Francisco.
I know. Is that home now, or do you just sort of divide your time?
Yeah, in between the two. Yeah,
right. And you got advice from, a world champ from AJ, didn't you? He gave you advice too.
I've achieved everything as an amateur, and I'd like to turn professional. And he said, yeah, you know, Nick, you should just go for it.
Go for it. And of course, you had a win. You would never... I mean, there's not a mark on you. There's not a mark on you.
I'm quick, Lorraine.
You are quick. You're really... I mean, that's part of the skill, isn't it? That's absolutely part of the skill. And boxing, not only did it change your life, it's also where you met your partner.
Yeah, yeah,
which is great. Now, she's a boxer as well.
Yeah, she is, yeah.
Ah, fantastic. And you're engaged now.
Yeah.
But you don't... I mean, you don't have to fight each other.
No.
Because that wouldn't work. There's the two of you there. You couldn't fight each other. It wouldn't work.
It'd be a bit weird.
It'd be just strange. But you train together, though. Can you do that together? You can train.
Yeah,
so that's okay. Oh, that's good. That's absolutely brilliant. And you're not... No plans for a wedding yet. You're just happy the way things are.
Yeah, yeah. Fantastic. Hopefully in the next couple of years.
Yeah.
Find some time somewhere.
I know. Maybe, I don't know, between bouts. So what's kind of the future like now, really? Is it just more fights, you know? Is that the way things will go?
Yeah, I'm working towards hopefully becoming a world champion at the end of the year.
So that's the goal?
Yeah, that's the goal.
God, that would be brilliant, wouldn't it? It'd be absolutely amazing. It would be incredible. And in the future, I mean, you know, you talked about people who inspired you. You're inspiring a whole new generation of girls that are coming up, which must be fantastic for you, because, you know, you've been the pioneer, really, haven't you?
Yeah, it's going to be nice to see when I retire and sit back. Even now I'm seeing the youths and juniors going to the Europeans and the World Championships, winning medals and the Junior Olympics. It's just nice to see.
It's like, I mean, the book's called Believe, and that's what you've had to do. Because we forget that while you were doing this, while you were up and coming, I mean, people weren't taking you seriously sometimes.
No,
they really weren't.
Yeah.
The fools. Yeah. The mad fools.
Yeah.
But they weren't. I mean, that's the struggle that you had. You know, obviously everybody coming after you is going to have their own struggles and their own problems and whatever, and successes too. But they won't have to do what you did.
No.
You've made it easier.
Yeah.
You really have.
Fighting for the change.
Absolutely. Nicola, it's always a joy to see you. It really is. Good luck with everything, and come back and see us when you're champ. That'll be great.
Will do.
I will look forward to it.